Welcome you all in my YouTube channel. Today we are learn about the space of bounded linear transformations. So let us begin from the definition, and this definition is definition of the linear space of all the linear transformations. Suppose XF and YF be two vector spaces, means X and Y are two linear spaces over the same field F, and LXY be the set of all the linear transformations from X to Y. So this LXY means collection of all the linear transformations from the vector space X to the vector space Y will become a vector space over the field F if it will satisfy, or if we defined the two operations, the vector addition and scalar multiplication, like this. So under these two operations, this set LXY of all linear transformations from the vector space X to the vector space Y will become a vector space over the same field F. The vector addition is like this: T1 plus T2 of X will be equals to T1X plus T2X for all X belongs to X. And a scalar multiplication is like this: alpha T1 of X will be equals to alpha times T1 of X for all X belongs to X. And these two operations are defined for all T1 and T2 belongs to LXY, and for all alpha belongs to F. And you can easily prove that under these two operations, the set LXY of all the linear transformations from the vector space X over F to the vector space Y over F will be a linear space, or we can say vector space. The linear space and vector space both are same. So let us move to the next section. In this section, we have some criterion for a non-empty subset of a vector space to be a subspace. So it is one of the famous criteria for a non-empty subset W of a vector space VF to be a subspace, and is that it will satisfy these two conditions. Means whenever X plus Y belongs to W, for all X, Y belongs to W, means W is closed under the vector addition. And second is alpha into X will be in W for all X belongs to X, and for all alpha belongs to F, means W will be closed under the scalar multiplication. Then W will be a subspace of the vector space VF, and conversely, means whenever W is a subspace of the vector space VF, then we must have these two results, 1 and 2. So by satisfying these two conditions, 1 and 2, we can show a particular subset W to be a subspace of the vector space VF. So it is one of the criteria for proving a subset to be a subspace. Now we can combine these two conditions by a single condition, and that is also one more correct criteria for showing a subset to be a subspace, and is that alpha x plus beta y will belongs to w for all x and y belongs to w and for all alpha beta belongs to f. If w satisfy this condition, then w will be a subspace of bf. And conversely, whenever w is a subspace of the vector space bf, then we must have this property. Okay, and one famous result is that for any subspace, or we can say for any vector space, there are at least two subspaces. First is V itself and another is zero. In case when number of element in V is greater than 1. So we must have subspaces for any vector space. So in today's class, our main target is to prove this theorem. This tells us that the set of all bounded linear transformations BXY defined from a non-linear space X to non-linear space Y will be a subspace of LXY. LXY is what? It is collection of all the linear transformations from the vector space X to the vector space Y. So let us prove this theorem. So let us write first. We have to show that BXY is a subspace of LXY. What is BXY? BXY is set of all bounded linear transformations defined from X to Y. And what is LXY? LXY is collection of all linear transformations defined from X to Y. So we are going to prove that BXY is a subspace of LXY. And for this, we use this criteria actually. This criteria tells us that for being a subspace, that should must closed under the addition, under the vector addition, and under the scalar multiplication. So we will show these two results one by one. So first of all, let us prove the result number one, that is BXY will be closed under the addition. So first of all, we show that this set BXY will be closed. It is closed under vector addition. Okay, we are going to show this result. So let T1 and T2 be the two elements in this set BXY, which is collection of all bounded linear transformations from X to Y. Then since they are bounded, so there exist finite real numbers K1 and K2, both are positive actually, such that T1x norm is less than equals to k1x. It is the bond of k1 is bond of t1, and t2x norm will be less than equals to k2 norm of x for all x belongs to x. So we must have these two conditions. The first one is due to boundedness of t1, and the second one is due to boundedness of t2, and k1 is one of the bond of t1 and k2 is one of the bond of t2. So let us call them 1. Next, consider the norm of this t1 plus t2 x. What is the norm of this expression? And by definition, it is norm of t1x plus t2x. This is by the definition of addition in the space Lxy. And this is less than equals to norm of first, that is norm of t1x plus norm of t2x, and this result is due to the property of norm. We know norm of any two vector, suppose a and a plus b, is always norm of a plus b is always less or equals to norm of a plus norm of b. So from this property we can write less than equals to this expression actually. Now the norm of t1x is actually less than equals to what? K1 into norm of x from result number 1, and this norm of t2x will be less than equals to k2 norm of x, and this expression is equals to k1 plus k2 into norm of x. And since k1 and k2 both are finite real numbers, and therefore their sum is also a finite real number, so this implies this t1 plus t2 x norm is less than or equals to k1 plus k2 into norm of x, and this will valid for all x belongs to x. So from this result we can say that k1 plus k2 is one of the bond of t1 plus t2. So this implies just that this real number k1 plus k2 is a bond of t1 plus t2. This means t1 plus t2 is a bonded linear map defined from x to y. So it will become a member of this collection BXY. Since BXY is the collection of all bonded linear transformations defined from x to y. And in this way, we can say the sum t1 plus t2 will be an element of BXY for every t1 and t2 belongs to BXY. Thus, our conclusion is like this. This t1 plus t2 will be a member of BXY for all t1, t2 belongs to BXY. Means BXY is closed under the vector addition. In the next step, we will show that this BXY is closed under scalar multiplication. स्केलर मल्टीप्लीकेशन। सो फॉर दिस लेट सम एलिमेंट टी इन बी एक्स वाई एंड सम स्केलर अल्फा बिलोंग्स टू सपोज फील्ड एफ ओवर विच एक्स एंड वाई आर लीनियर स्पेसेस। नाउ लेट अस इवेल्युएट द नॉर्म ऑफ दिस एक्सप्रेशन अल्फा टी ऑफ एक्स। नॉर्म ऑफ अल्फा टी ऑफ एक्स विल बी बाय द डिफिनेशन इट विल बी अल्फा टी एक्स नॉर्म ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट एंड दिस इज बाय डिफिनेशन सिंस अल्फा इज ए स्केलर सो वी कैन राइट मोड ऑफ अल्फा इंटू टी एक्स नॉर्म एंड मोड ऑफ अल्फा विल बी सम रियल नंबर सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट। नाउ सिंस दिस टी इज बॉन्डेड ड्यू टू इट इज अ मेंबर ऑफ बॉन्डेड लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस फ्रॉम एक्स टू वाई इट इज अ मेंबर ऑफ बी एक्स वाई विच इज कलेक्शन ऑफ ऑल द बॉन्डेड लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस फ्रॉम एक्स टू वाई सो टी मस्ट बी बॉन्डेड एंड देयरफॉर वी कैन फाइंड अ रियल नंबर ऑब्वियसली पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर के such that the norm of tx, this is norm of tx, will be less than or equals to k times norm of x. And this is valid for all x belongs to x. So, now we use this result in this place. Suppose this is result number 2. Using this result in 2, we get, so by using this result in 2, we have this result, alpha t x norm, it is in the left hand side of 2 and the right hand side will be less than equals to this expression mod of alpha and norm of tx is actually less than equals to k into norm of x. So let us write k into norm of x in this place and the value in the right hand side must be larger than the left hand side. So we have this result. Now this result tells us that mod alpha into k is a bond of alpha t. So this result implies us that reason is that this is actually valid for all x belongs to x since x is arbitrary. So this implies us that alpha t of x norm will be less than equals to mod of alpha into k into norm of x for all x belongs to x. And this result implies just that mod of alpha into k is a bond of this linear transformation alpha t. And this implies just that alpha t is also a bonded linear transformation. So it will be an element of bxy. Since bxy is the collection of all bonded linear transformations defined from x to y. And therefore, we can conclude like this that alpha t will be always in bxy for all t belongs to bxy and alpha belongs to f. So bxy is now become closed under the vector addition as well as under the scalar multiplication. This means this Bxy must be a subspace of the vector space Lxy. Okay, one more point here is that this Bxy can never be empty. Why? Since one mapping, that is zero mapping is like this, that is x to y defined by zero of x equal to zero. So if we define mapping from x to y like this, zero of x equals to zero for all x belongs to x, then this is a member of Bxy. Why? Since zero of x norm is equals to zero norm, and zero norm is zero, and this zero can be written like this, zero into norm of x. So we have this result that zero x norm is equals to mod of zero into norm of x, or we can write is equals to zero. So simply it is zero into norm of x. So in place of k we have zero, and this zero is a scalar zero, not that this is a scalar zero, this zero is a scalar zero. So zero is the bound of this zero mapping, and therefore zero mapping is a bounded linear transformation from x to y, and therefore this zero mapping is one of the element of Bxy. So this Bxy must be non-empty, and hence we can say that Bxy is now closed under the vector addition as well as the scalar multiplication. This means this Bxy will become a subspace of the vector space Lxy. It is a subspace of Lxy. Now we know subspace means it is itself a vector space. So it means this Bxy is a vector space, or we can say linear space. So this is very important result in our point of view, since in the next class we are going to show that this Bxy is a norm linear space under the suitable definition of norm, and further it will become a Banach space provided Y will be Banach space. So what is the interesting in the our next theorem is for the completeness of this Bxy depends only on Y, means it will complete if Y is complete and doesn't depends upon X. So today's theorem is over.